Hey everyone, Patrick LeBlanc, Principal Program Manager for Microsoft Fabric. We've got some exciting demos lined up focused on data engineering, so let's just dive right in. First up, we're taking a deeper look into the ESRI's ArcGIS GeoAnalytics integration with Microsoft Fabric Spark. If you're into mapping, this is one demo you won't want to miss. It's really cool. Definitely check it out. Next, the Fabric team has something everyone's been buzzing about: row and column level security for Spark. Yes, you heard that right. This one is a must watch. You'll see how to enhance your data governance with fine-grained security controls and so much more. Now, let's get started with the first demo. Arshad, take it away.
ESRI is recognized as the global market leader in geographic information system, or GIS technology, location intelligence, and mapping, primarily through its flagship software, ArcGIS. ESRI empowers businesses, governments, and communities to tackle the world's most pressing challenges through spatial analysis and location insights. We are truly excited to announce that Microsoft and ESRI have partnered to bring spatial analytics into Microsoft Fabric. Our collaboration with ESRI will introduce cutting-edge visual spatial analytics right within Microsoft Fabric, Spark notebooks, and Spark job definitions, which is available across both data engineering and data science experiences. Let's take a look at how we can generate data insights by exploring the predictive impact natural disasters have on insured properties. We have this data set of insured properties that have actual individual point locations attached to them in the lakehouse, like latitude, longitude. Let's read this data in a Spark notebook and plot it to analyze it better with ESRI provided base map for context. As you can notice, we have here too much data to see a clear pattern. So let's transform the data to uncover the pattern of our interest. For instance, summarizing the total number of policies by hexagonal bins, or counting the total insured values in millions of dollars as shown here. Beyond just visualizing distribution, we can ask more complex analysis questions like how risky these insurance policies are. For that, we can bring a dataset from ArcGIS Living Atlas of the World with data for FEMA National Risk Index, where each census tract has risk rating. Using a spatial join, we can combine this data with insured property so that policy is enriched with risk index, risk score, and risk rating. Our policy records are now a lot smarter and can be written back to Lakehouse to be used across our organization for additional analysis and modeling. We can also visualize summarized results in Power BI dashboard, for instance, filtering for location with highest risk policies. We can quickly explore areas where an insurance company may be carrying too much risk relative to other areas in their portfolio. We may also want to understand the impact of natural hazards or current events. Let's bring a data set with probabilities of hurricane force winds over a 5-day period. This can be explored visually, but to use this information effectively, we need the hurricane force wind data to be spatially tied to our insured properties. Spatial join links insured properties with wind speed probabilities, and with that, for each property, we now know the likelihood of hurricane force winds. The enriched data can be used in Power BI for interactive exploration to identify total insured value by probabilities of hurricane force wind. In summary, this is just a small example of what is possible with the spatial analytics in Microsoft Fabric. We just looked at a set of insured data that we could enrich especially to answer a number of critical questions about potential impact based on upcoming natural disaster. But there are so much more you can do with this power in your hand.
In this demo, we will learn about Fabric User Data Functions, aka Fabric UDFs. What is Fabric User Data Functions? It's a collection of functions you can create to handle specific tasks that require custom code. They help you manage your data efficiently by turning complex operations into reusable functions. You can use these functions across different data sets and workflows in the Fabric ecosystem. They also support Git integration and deployment pipelines, making it easy to deploy and release your changes quickly. UDFs are serverless in nature and use a simple programming model, which reduces the time to code. By using Fabric capacity units, you only pay for what you use. You can integrate with data pipelines and Fabric notebooks for advanced analytical solutions. You can also enhance your Power BI reports to make them more dynamic with real-time data updates. To get started, navigate to a workspace of your choice. Search for user data functions and provide a name for your function item. Select New Function to get started. This will publish a Hello Fabric template that you can build on. You can edit the code by clicking on the editor or use the Edit tab. You can add, update, or remove functions. You can use the IntelliSense support to simplify your editing experience, allowing you to code faster. Let's write a new function that actually works with the data in your Fabric SQL database. Select Manage Connections to add one or more connections to a data source. I will select the Fabric SQL database, and this will create an alias for the data connection that I can then reference in my code. The fastest way to develop a function is to use the samples feature. Add a sample that runs a select query for a SQL database. Use udf.connection to pass the connection alias and an argument name to reference it. In this case, the alias is demo_database1. There is no need to pass a connection string. UDF securely validates the permissions and access to the data. If you want to customize the code and use a Python library, select Library Management to add any public library from PyPI. Here, I'm adding Pandas library that I can use to transform the data and return the desired output. In the code, you can add an import statement and start using the library. Now that our function code is ready, let's publish these changes. Once it's successfully published, you can test your function to validate it. Select Run. Since this function doesn't take any parameters, you will see the records from the select query in the output. To manage any function, select the function in the Function Explorer. Select View Historical Logs to see all the invocation logs every time the function was executed. Use the logger in the UDF code to write your own custom logs. For UDFs with public access enabled, you can copy the function URL and invoke it from an external application. You may have many UDFs across multiple workspaces. Use Functions Hub to view and manage all the UDFs you own or you have access to. To summarize, you just learned what a Fabric user data function is, when to use it, and how to get started with writing your first function. Thank you for watching.
As a data analyst, I open a notebook for writing Spark SQL code to view the data. There are two tables. The first one contains employee details, but I shouldn't have access to Social Security column. Select All returns me only results I have access to applying CLS restrictions. The second table contains orders, and as an analyst, I only should see US region orders. Spark applies row-level filtering and gives me results only for accessible region.
The Fabric Spark connector for Fabric Data Warehouse empowers Spark developers and data scientists to access and work with data from Fabric Data Warehouse and the SQL Analytics endpoint of Lakehouse using simplified Spark API. Let's first start by creating a table in Data Warehouse and accessing it using the simplified API in Spark. On a Spark side, you can apply different APIs like filter to filter rows, select to select selected column, or limit the number of rows coming from data warehouse. Not only that, you can create a view in data warehouse and access this view using the same simplified API that we offer. This connector honors row level and column level security defined at data warehousing level. Here is an example of row level security in action. We recently added a feature to write data back to a data warehousing table of a data frame. It allows writing data into multiple modes. If you are a Python developer, we are thrilled to announce that this connector has full PySpark support now.
Those demos were pretty awesome, right? Hit us up with your number one takeaway. And if you've got any questions, drop them where? In the comments below. Is there a specific demo you want to see next month? Let us know. And remember to like, comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on all the latest updates from Microsoft Fabric.